Good evening, everybody. Welcome to She Said, She Said. It's another Saturday night, and thank you for joining us. But you know what, Jax? I think they'll be thanking us for featuring who we have on the show tonight.
I know. I think every Saturday, they're going to thank us.
I know, right? Because tonight on the show, we're going to be having some neophyte congressmen.
Mm-hmm.
But they're not really neophytes.
Because they were in...
They all had some sort of public service. Like one was a governor,
mm-hmm.
one was a counselor, one was, I think, a provincial board member. So they've all had their share of politics.
Yeah, so only neophytes in Congress.
Neophytes in Congress. Like, you know how we have like 23 mayors and mm-hmm. 32 like governors? They're all first-time neophyte congressmen, but they've been in service for a while.
Okay. So they are actually three, and she said one is the sweetest. And I'd like to thank him for the chicharron.
The adobong chicharron that we ate last week.
I love it.
I know, right? Okay. That was from him.
Yeah, I know. Thank you very much to him. And then the other one is her favorite co-host. Wait, I thought I was your favorite co-host.
I know, but your in Congress.
Male co-host.
In Congress, because we have neophyte nights. Uh-huh. So during neo nights, he's my co-host. Actually, it started as me being his co-host.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because
I will say your favorite male co-host.
Right, yeah.
Yes. Okay.
There you go.
And then the other one...
After you meet him, he'll be your favorite male co-host
really?
Too. Yeah.
Okay. And then the other one, her cousin...
Yes, my cousin Mitzi.
Mitzi went to Congress and she said that he was the cutest congressman there.
Yeah, she said, hey, who's that? I'm like, who, where, what? And she goes, the guy, he's really cute. And I'm like, oh, him. But they're going to have to wait a little longer before they get to know these three neophyte congressmen who are going to be on the show tonight.
So,
well, she says,
mm-hmm.
if all the congressmen look like this, she's going to be running for Congress in the next election. There you go.
Yeah.
I was convincing you to run 2010.
Yeah, I know, but I didn't know there were going to be congressmen like that.
Oh, so many young ones, so many single ones.
So many
we
new ones,
we were trying
ones.
To like
yes.
count, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, don't go away. We'll be right back and you'll get a chance to meet the neophyte when you return. We are back here on She Said, She Said, and this is so exciting.
I know.
Can you feel it?
This is like a party.
This is the reason why you guys are tuning in. We've got with us today on the show.
We have three neophyte congressmen.
Yes. And the reason why Jackie will run for Congress next year. Next time. Huwag naman next year. Mga in 3 years.
In 3 years. Yeah. Two and a half more years.
2.1.
You all have to be there.
They're all neophytes, so they all
have two more terms to go. 3 more terms to go.
Let's introduce them.
Okay.
First, we have, over on the left-hand side, Congressman Luigi Quisumbing.
Hello.
Of, hi, Luigi.
6th District, Cebu City. That's Mandaue, right?
That's Luigi, Mandaue City and 2 towns.
Yes, thank you very much for the adobong chicharron. I ate, and you know, she even brought it with suka.
That's the only way to
and
have
I
it.
And I love suka, and we were eating it during the show. And
yeah, and
thank
I would have brought you some of the chocolate cake. I'm like, it's so good, it has to be a sin. And he's
but
like,
she finished
it's
it
called
all.
Mortal Sin Cake. Yeah, but I finished
well,
it.
It didn't survive the trip, but we'll try to find a way to get it here to Manila.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
And beside Luigi, we have the guy who I said is my favorite co-host because without him, we don't want to start.
Male co-host. Yeah.
Let's clarify that.
And soon to be my favorite male co-host. Yeah, I said
Congressman Miro Quimbo. Marikina.
Hi.
Hello, Miro. Hello?
He just looks like that now, but wait and watch.
We never got to taste at adobo. I mean, adobo chicharron.
Oh, you didn't get that? Well, no, sorry for you.
Luigi just gives it to women.
Okay. Then just stick to the women.
That's right.
Stay beside them. Right. So
he's single. So
it's a Cebuano connection.
Yeah.
Cebuano connection.
No, because Cebuano women.
Wait, you're single as in single?
Single, absolutely.
Free single and ready to mingle.
Pristine.
No girlfriend?
Nope, no girlfriend.
Really? Okay.
And here we have another single, but not for too long.
Really?
Yeah. Oh,
let's not talk to him anymore.
I told you, my cousin Mitzi went to Congress and she said...
Yeah, and she was looking around and she said, I mean, not that you're not cute. I mean, I know you are, but she said,
who is that?
He is the cutest.
Yeah. And I go, where, who?
Yeah, see?
So it was Congressman Dax Kua, Kazan.
Hi, Dax.
Kirino. No, district. Sorry.
Good evening,
sorry, Tito Junie.
Okay, so before you were congressman, you were?
I was 29 years old.
And he was a governor. He was a governor. And
so humble. You were a governor for
what?
How?
You mean 29? How old are you now? You're only 29?
29
I'm
and
only
a half.
30 now.
Are you serious?
No,
I'm just kidding. I'm 33.
Oh, man.
My gosh, you're a guy. Why are you shy to say your age?
I know. Yeah, but he swapped with his dad.
Oh, okay. So yeah. you had 3 terms as governor? Or?
No, just 3 years.
3 years. So one term.
Okay. And before that?
Before that, twice vice governor.
And before that, you were 22 years old.
23.
And Luigi used to be before you ran for Congress?
I was a provincial board member back in 2004.
Right.
And you were single?
No, he was a counselor.
Single. No, this is my first time to run for politics.
Okay.
I mean, to run for office. None of my siblings, not my father.
You weren't a counselor
as a lawyer,
before?
No.
Are you serious?
You were a lawyer?
I still am. Yeah. I still am.
You got this bar 10 minutes ago.
Yeah.
Okay, do you sing well?
No, absolutely not.
Because you have a nice voice.
I've never tried singing.
Okay, try now.
Truly.
Well, how do you campaign?
Dance?
No, I don't dance. I never sang. I never danced.
You just host.
But I seriously wanted to dance and sing.
Well, you can do it
genuinely,
now.
But
now that you have won, it's your chance to do it.
No, don't forget, we just had the Ondoy celebration or commemoration a few months ago.
Yes.
So let's not get into singing.
No, dancing. Seriously, but you wanted to sing? Why don't you?
I did. I've never found a song which I feel like I can carry with confidence. Honestly.
Oh, wait. Luigi has a term for it. What would you call it, Luigi? The what song?
The power song.
The power,
power song.
There you go. I was thinking of that
Luigi,
yesterday.
Luigi, I want to ask you, what makes you smile? You're always smiling.
He's always smiling.
Well, I love it.
Well, you know, it's... We get to... speaking on behalf of the four of us here, we get to pretty much live our dreams. This is a dream job for most of us,
mm-hmm.
To be in the House of Representatives. We get to try to do some good for our district. We get to... hopefully help to shape and mold the policies of our land. It's a tremendous feeling. It's definitely something worth smiling about.
Yeah, good. I have a question for the four of you. What was your most unforgettable experience during the campaign?
Wow, that's hard to remember.
Okay, I'll start.
Yes,
I'll start.
Okay.
There was this person who would always like go to me when I go to that barangay and would always like help out. And one day, she went like this to her back, and right in the back here, she tattooed Cutie Del Mar.
Wow.
I'm like, okay,
wait.
I'm so thoughtful.
Girl,
guys
girl?
Ever done that for me?
A girl.
A girl.
A real kind of girl.
Well,
girl,
I guess,
boy,
I guess
girl.
She was like a girl, boy, girl, or, you know, I don't know, but it doesn't matter.
Okay, how did
and
you
then,
feel?
And my brother said, tell her to capitalize the D, because Del Mar's like Del Mar.
My God.
Stalker alert.
What was it, just your name? Did it have
she
picture
She tattooed, like, my whole name right here,
oh
right? And I was like, oh, my God.
And she was following you?
No, following, like, helping, like, making sure, you know, the way is paved and all. And,
so
yeah.
Is she your best friend now?
No. She texts every now and then, and I reply every now and then.
Well, okay, say hi to her.
Did she put cutie or did she put Rachel Marguerite?
I know,
that's
right?
That's more painful tattoo.
It's more painful, yeah, more blood.
I know, yeah, okay.
What you're not telling, Jack, is the fact that there are probably a few congressmen who have already etched your name into
but
there.
But you haven't seen it.
Yeah.
Secret lang yun.
No.
Secret.
Si Luigi, alam ni Luigi.
I think I know who that is.
Okay, tell me later,
ah. Okay, wait. Why is this about me? About me lang, about the tattoo. Now, let's turn to the boys. Okay,
okay, who wants
unforgettable.
To...
Unforgettable. Who's ready for one? Dax, you?
No, I'm not ready.
Okay, Luigi.
It's pretty much the whole point of a campaign is that everything is new. I'm really a true neophyte in the sense that my family doesn't have political experience.
Mm-hmm.
When I ran in 2004, 2007, and 2010, it really was just going through so many new experiences, each one different. They were, some were funny, some were heartbreaking, some were really, really
Heartbreaking, you know. In what way?
Oh, well, you really see some of the worst conditions.
Yes.
That our country has. You see the most abject poverty. You see the most heartbreaking cases, no? Especially when you see some people that need some medical assistance or people mm-hmm. that have gone through tragedy. It's really something that, given our upbringing, that we may never have gotten to see if we didn't go into this,
uh-huh.
if we didn't go into politics.
Yes.
And that's also what fuels all of us. That's mm-hmm. also what gives us motivation to continue to do what we're doing
yeah.
so that we can try to alleviate some of that.
Mm-hmm. Luigi here comes from the family that owns Marcus. Yes, Miro?
No, heartbreaking can also...
I know.
No, heartbreaking can also mean... Yeah, like Luigi, I'm an absolute neophyte.
Mm-hmm.
But heartbreaking can also mean the experience with betrayal, with people.
Oh, yes.
Oh, that can be really heartbreaking. I mean, mm-hmm. you know, you've been with somebody over the last few months, literally eating from the same plate, and then come crunch time, you find out that he's on the other side. I mean, those are the,
yeah.
I mean, aside from the people situation,
yeah.
those are the things that kind of make you not want to get into it again, but obviously it's part of the menu of things
yes.
that
but
you have to go through.
Then you feel how blessed you are after that.
Absolutely. I mean, I think, you know, Luigi and myself, I'm sure Dax feels that same way. I mean, growing up, I always knew that this is what I wanted to do.
Really?
Really?
Always.
How old were you when you thought that?
4 or 5 years old. Meaning
really?
None
how,
of my,
how so? How did that, do you have like
I was the,
politics
I,
in your
I was
family?
The youngest of 10.
Mm-hmm.
I had six
10.
Older brothers. And, you know, I always liked being with people more
mm-hmm.
than my friends or even my siblings. I always, I was always delighted with the stories that ordinary people would tell me.
Yeah. Wait, sorry. You prefer to be with more people than your siblings? You prefer to be with the people than...
Like the villagers?
Or you prefer to be with the people more than your brothers and sisters prefer to be with the people?
I like being with my brothers and sisters. I mean, we're a pretty close-knit family, but I think my affinity or my propensity to be with people is higher than most people my age. Meaning,
mm-hmm.
I absolutely enjoy having a drink in a corner with strangers. I mean,
really?
Hearing their stories,
oh,
their frustrations,
okay.
and you feel like you're empowered. You're placed in a position where you can genuinely help.
Help, yes. So
it can be frustrating at times, but I think, you know, that's how lucky we feel in a sense.
Mm-hmm. So what was your most unforgettable experience?
I think like what Luigi said, I mean, the entire experience by itself was entirely new and everything was just unforgettable in that respect. I think there are too many things to speak of. Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're going to ask Dax and you can't have the same answer just because they had the same
okay.
answers.
Okay.
But when we come back, we'll
yes.
give them time to think about
yes,
it.
Yes, I was
yeah.
going to say that because
that's
we're friends.
No, that's not. You can change your answer before
that's
I change my answer.
Tattooed.
You're making
you're
me
okay.
look so baba with your answers. Oh, it's a tattoo. So when we come back, we'll hear from the boys. So don't go away. You're still watching She Said, She Said with us are Congressman Luigi, Congressman Miro, and Congressman Dax. So we were just asking them a while ago, well, Jackie gave them the question, and your question was?
Yes, what is the most unforgettable moment you've had during the campaign?
Well, just like both of them, the whole campaign itself is memorable. But for
nakakainis
me,
naman tong
the thing I like about the campaign is it's very exciting. Coming from being governor previously, people think that it's an advantage to be a sitting governor or an incumbent official running for office.
Mm-hmm.
But in actually, being an incumbent makes you more accountable to the people.
Yeah.
As opposed to being a newcomer, you can just criticize and present your platform. Us incumbents had to defend what we did and explain the programs that we did and how we're going to continue and move forward from those. So that's the exciting part, answering the critics,
mm-hmm.
which are always more than, of course, the incumbents cannot really critique someone who's not in office, right? Mm-hmm.
So what was the main difference when you were running for governor and now that you were running for Congress?
Well, not much.
You would do house to house still?
Yeah, not much. We did the same routine. The whole team, the whole lineup went around the entire province. We went to all barangays.
Yeah, would you sing?
No, I didn't. I don't sing.
Did you regret that?
I feel that my singing will probably lessen my vote. So I'd rather not risk that.
Really?
But was it easy because your dad had been congressman since what, 1987? He started out the same as my dad. Yes. They were
same time.
They were batchmates. Like we're batchmates.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Cool.
So was it easier because your dad's in office?
Well, definitely it's easier because the team is unified. We have a strong, cohesive local party that really, really campaigns all out. You know, you have the mayors campaigning for the congressman and the congressman campaigning for the mayors and vice versa. So it becomes a team effort as opposed to just carrying your own weight. So much easier.
All three of you would like to stay on for three terms? As of now? As of today?
Okay, I was asking Dax because I said from being a governor, you kind of find the pace of Congress maybe a little slow because they're so used to being on the go. So I said, are you going to swap with your dad after this term? And to which he replied,
it will depend on the people. I really don't know.
It's too early to tell?
It's too early to tell. Of course, being a congressman has a lot of exciting features to it, like you get to craft laws, and that's really an influence not only to your district but to the whole country, diba? So your horizons are broadened. You're looking at the big picture now. You're not just you're working for your district and your representation, but you're looking at the big picture. So it's kind of a challenge to balance both worlds.
Yes.
It's interesting, diba?
I think it's more difficult for people like that because, I mean, they were the king in their own kingdoms. Mm-hmm. You talk about the mayors or the governors are with us today. I think there was a huge adjustment in terms of suddenly you're thrust also in a much bigger pond where every congressman thinks he's king. Mm-hmm. So I think for a great number of them, the adjustment in terms of the working environment posed a challenge. But of course, you know, like in Dax's case, I mean, if you excel locally, if you excel as a governor, you'll eventually excel also in Congress. But there's 50% premium really on learning how to make pakisama with the rest. That's it. I mean, you feel like sometimes you have great ideas, but you have to watch your step. Just be careful not to try to outshine everybody. I don't think that's not necessarily bad, you know.
Okay, who tries to do that? You can like mention like a few names. You can just give us initials.
Excuse me, the question was, do I want to stay over the next 9 years?
No, this is the next question.
Answering that question will mean me not wanting to stay over the next
Everything was getting so serious. I want to know, like Miro was saying that when he was 4 or 5, he already wanted to enter politics.
Or priesthood.
Think everybody wanted to be a priest in some time in their life.
Yeah, is
and
that
then,
true?
Well, I don't know. Yeah. I can't be a priest.
Are you kidding? Yeah, you're kidding?
Yes, I wanted
I
to
wanted
be.
To be a nun.
You'd make a hot nun. I mean,
why a priest, Mira?
Well, my mother was deeply religious. She still is.
So she was instilling it in your brain?
She wanted at least one of the 7 brothers to become a priest. So I was the youngest one.
Okay,
so,
but what?
She was so wrong in thinking you.
She was very unsuccessful with the 6 older ones. I was the last hope.
Can I say, if you were a priest, I think your church or your chapel would be full all the time.
He has the gift of gab, so.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay,
but
so
I don't know how long you'd stay
what,
there.
What in the priesthood did you like? Or that?
Wait. Did you hear that?
What did
you
say?
I don't know what my religion would be.
Well, so what in the priesthood did you like? What interested you?
I like the fact that I was going to mass. I was hungry and thirsty, but the priest could eat and bigger host.
He's exempted from all that. Right?
No, I think the fact that people listened to him each time when people were troubled.
He must have had a good parish priest.
Well, I initially grew up in the province of Samar, and you know the priests are always revered, mm-hmm. Particularly when in times of trouble, they're the council that you really go to. So I like that.
You like that. You like the feeling that people come to you for help, and you like the feeling of helping them.
No, I think I like the fact that you are reposed in a particular position, and you feel yung you can actually help people.
Mm-hmm. At what age did you let go of the priest dream?
No, 12 when I started
dating,
getting to meet girls. Okay. I was told that priests couldn't get married. I said, to hell with that priest. That's a lot of crap.
Okay, well, what about Luigi? What did you want to be when you were 5?
You know, I've been very privileged. I follow in a long line of successful businessmen, and mm-hmm. all through my life, that's all I wanted to be, is the next generation of that legacy. But you know, my mom and my dad have always been very, very aggressive, mm-hmm. and really trying to push that you have to also be socially responsible, not just worry about how your company's doing, how mm-hmm. the family's doing, but also try to open up the world to the world at large. Make sure that you make the world around you a better place, not just what's within the walls of your factory's compound. So because of doing outreach programs, because we have our charities for our company, it really wanted me to try to make a larger impact. As representative, as congressman, it's one way that I feel that I can do exactly that. I'm 31. I'm under no significant pressure to be full-time with our family's business yet, so...
Mm-hmm. Or to get married.
Or to get married. So at this point, maybe
that
I can
you
continue
smile,
to
huh?
help the community at this
Why
point.
Why are you the mama? Where were you last night?
Where was I last night?
On a Friday night.
On a Friday night.
On a Friday night, what were you doing?
You're always blushing.
Home, watching TV.
Yeah, right.
Who's home?
This guy gets a
hot chocolate.
I know, yeah.
Popcorn, that's all. What kind of
business would you like to get in?
Well, our family business.
Still in your family business, not outside of that.
Yes. You know, it's been very good to us. Obviously, all of these opportunities we wouldn't have if the business wasn't there. Of course.
And what business is this?
Norgis. Mm-hmm. We do financing. We have sales as well of some products. It's provided a lot of opportunities for myself, my sister, my cousins, our entire family. And because of that, we all want to see it grow. We all want to see it continue to prosper. That's why we've had the opportunity to go to very good schools. Mm-hmm. We've had the opportunity to travel to make sure that we don't become the cliche that of the Chinese proverb that the third generation destroys what the generations before it have already begun.
Mm-hmm.
And we want
to
make sure that doesn't happen.
But that sounds fun, huh?
to destroy.
You know, Miro, when you were speaking, he was smiling, but you weren't saying anything funny, but he was smiling.
No, because Miro.
I mean, our dream for these guys, you know, eventually open a. Maybe like a really nice bar. I mean,
they don't call him chairman for nothing.
That's right. He's the chairman of the board.
Uh-huh. Yeah, we're gonna have to wait to hear Dax again when we come back.
See, so you have more time now again.
Yeah. So when we return, so meantime, add us on your Facebook fan page. She said, and check out their pages as well and add them right here. Don't go away.
Nagbabalik po ang she said, and yes, it's your turn. Yes, the question was...
What did you want to be when you were younger?
Oh yeah, I was very fickle when I was 5. I went through priesthood. I wanted to be an army officer or a general.
Where
I wanted
that come
to be
from?
Yeah.
An admiral of a ship.
Where'd you get those?
From G.I. Joe, where else? I wanted to be Superman.
Superman!
And then when I realized... how much influence the president can make. I said I wanted to be the president.
No.
Until that changed again. One thing I never wanted to be was a doctor.
Okay, I'm with you there.
Because you don't like blood, like
I can't stand needles or blood.
Well, so you're the same. Yeah, she does. She can't stand that either.
Wow, okay. So at what age did you decide, okay, I'm going to go follow my dad's footsteps?
Well, seeing how my parents served our province, I always thought that I might end up there eventually.
That's right. His mom was also a congressman at one point, right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's why. But I never thought that I'd be in it this early in my life. I entered when I was 23. I've been here for 9 years now, and it's been like a year only, but it's now 10 years, right?
Yes.
Were you the youngest vice god at that time?
Yeah, I was at 23. That's the minimum age.
Right.
The minimum age is 23.
Yeah. Are there any other guys? I mean, I travel all the time with his parents, to June and to Marianne.
Yeah, I have two younger brothers.
And did they get into politics as well?
No.
So you're the eldest?
I'm the eldest son. I have two elder sisters.
And two younger brothers.
Yeah.
And you are the only one in politics.
Middle child. I'm a middle child too.
I'm a middle child.
It doesn't show.
Yeah, what are the signs of a middle child?
What are the signs of the youngest?
Let's go back to that.
Let's go back to that.
What doesn't show?
I met him, maybe 8 years ago when he was like a new vice governor.
How did you meet?
We had the housing program in the province. I used to work with Pag-ibig Fund. He was so young. I mean,
And he was part of the delegation that we had an inauguration.
Did you think he looks too young? No credibility?
No, not no credibility, but
really,
he thought so. Was he nice?
No, but he had just come out of UP, so I thought it was a wonderful opportunity for him. I mean, having somebody young.
And did you keep in touch, or you only saw each other again in Congress after?
Yeah.
Just in Congress. Ah. Yeah.
Right before. Again.
Yeah, right
So
before.
Was he nice to you?
Yeah, he pretended to be nice to
you. It's hard, but somebody
was good at it.
Huh?
So we have this thing called Neophyte Night, which Dak started. So he invited all the neophytes to a dinner, which he hosted. Nice of him, very generous.
Hosted in a restaurant or in your house?
At a hotel, yeah.
Okay.
And then he made Mira host, and Mira, of course, I don't know what happened, how I ended up co-hosting too. And then
there was a huge clamor, petition signing.
Do you close the whole restaurant?
Dax did.
Okay, how many new congressmen and women are there?
Around about 114,
116
now.
109 are actual absolute virgins.
Oh.
Meaning have never been in Congress before.
Okay. Yeah.
We have come back in once.
Clarified that.
We have come back in once. Yeah. Like 30,
they were already in Congress
of them.
And then they
But 109 come in. That's like absolutely first time.
So when you have those neophyte nights, how many attend?
Around 60.
Yeah.
Around 60.
Oh, okay. And then you have a program that you host?
We have a program and...
Well, it's your chance to sing.
People,
the first night, it was just us going around and asking people to say something about themselves, and it turned out to be really funny. I mean, Mira's just the perfect guy to host something like that.
What did you say about yourself?
I don't remember. I was too drunk.
Already?
Yeah.
It hadn't even started. You were drunk already.
No, the program started late. I had to be drunk to accept the challenge.
It was really fun. So since then, people from that night. From that night, people had offered. Okay, I'll host the next one. Mm-hmm. So we've had people host it like. The next month, we had J.V. Harrison. He hosted Rakioki Night.
Mm-hmm.
So he got a band, and everyone would just go up one by one and sing. And people were really game.
Uh-huh.
And they had nice voices, right? That's where the...
Except
what song? Power song.
Except
Mira,
did Cutie sing? She sings well.
Yeah, I sang with
Manny.
I sang Manny.
What did you sing?
What did I sing? Bakit ngayon ka lang? Yung walang kamatayang bakit ngayon ka lang?
And he knew the song.
Yeah, he did.
Manny Pacquiao got knocked out.
And then next to that, we had our Halloween night in costume, which was sponsored by Mark Villar.
Okay.
And then November, this month, we're having Manny Pacquiao's hosting our Neophyte Night.
Oh. What was your costume then?
Don't remind us. Don't remind us.
I forgot.
Yeah.
What was yours? Anyway, so So we have it, and hopefully we're gonna be able to have it. Mm-hmm. Because so far it's been, I've been asking like the other congressmen, has it been that way with your batch? And
yeah, so far it does. It, I don't remember my dad doing any of that.
Well, it actually started maybe 8 weeks before Congress started. Dax, myself, and a few other members of Congress started meeting up for. We had a couple of all these orientation things.
Yeah. Oh yes, yes, yes.
For newbies, mm-hmm. And we started organizing. We wanted it to be we want this Congress to be different. Mm-hmm. Meaning, we want the 15th Congress neophytes to be there over the next